Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to another video. I hope you are doing good and are enjoying the holiday season. And I'm actually coming to you from a new space. Since I filmed my last video and filming this one, I have moved, which is why there was a little bit of a gap between the two videos. But I am now settled down, so I should be posting more videos in the upcoming weeks and months. So I'm really excited to get back on track and start filming more videos. But in this video, I wanted to talk about something a little bit different, and I feel like I've been saying that in pretty much every single video over the past couple of videos, but this is a little different for my channel. I normally talk about beauty and fashion and all of that good stuff, and that's still very much going to be a large chunk of my channel. But in this video, I wanted to talk about, well, coziness. As you can probably tell from the title, I'm going to share with you my favorite tips on how you can be a little bit more cozy. I don't know why I'm saying it like that. For some reason, that just seems kind of like awkward to say. But I was inspired by the Little Book of Hygge, which is just happens to be right there. I don't know how it got there, probably because I just placed it there. But I love, love, love this book, and I have read it so many times, actually three or four, and I've recently reread it and was inspired by it. And so I wanted to share with you some of the tips from this book and my personal tips on how you can be a little bit more cozy, especially now that A, it is the holiday season, B, it's winter time, and C, it is still 2020. So we're all going to be staying indoors more often, and a little bit of coziness will do us all some good. Now, my first tip is lighting, and it's actually something that's emphasized highly in the book as well. And I totally understand why, because I think good lighting makes or breaks the space. I think we've all been in places with like that really stark fluorescent lights on the ceilings, and this just, it's not very warm or cozy or inviting. It might be very functional for some spaces, but it's not cozy. So one of my favorite things in the entire world, just aside from even the whole cozy factor, is hue lights. Now, hue lights is actually what I'm surrounded with because I have them all over the room. The best thing about these lights is that you can make them nice and bright and white during the day if you need the extra light, but then you can also make them nice and cozy and dim and like a fire color, orangey kind of amber fire color at night, and really transform your space and transform your room. And as a bonus, it's really good for your circadian rhythm to not have to deal with all, you know, super bright blue lights in the evening. That's actually the reason I got them in the first place, but then one of the side effects I've noticed is that my room was really cozy and very kind of like inviting and relaxing in the evenings. I have one right here. I have a little lamp right there. This is actually a whole lamp, and this lamp is like a normal lamp, but I have a Hue light bulb in there. And then I have a lamp over there that also has it. So I'm surrounded by them, but they're super, super incredible and just a great addition. Now, you don't have to get Hue light bulbs. You can also get regular LED light bulbs, but the warmer and the dimmer the light, the better it is for the cozy factor, which is probably the term I'm going to use here in this video. And then also, the more small lights you can place around the room, the better, as opposed to having one large one. I think that's actually mentioned in the book as well. Now, another way to add a little bit more coziness through lighting is actually to add some string lights or some fairy lights on your windows, or, you know, whatever. If you can find yourself some really nice string lights, some pretty ones, they make a wonderful cozy atmosphere in the room. Now, my second tip is to either light a candle or put on a fire if you have a fireplace, or to put on a fake fire, which I was totally against until I've tried it, I think 2 months ago or something like that. I actually have a vlog where I did try the fake fireplace and I loved it, surprisingly. I always thought it was going to be just bad, but it's actually really, really good. So if you don't have a fireplace and you don't want to light a candle, you can always resort to putting a fake fire, which is surprisingly really good and like soothing. Candles are also great, and the book is, it talks about candles a lot. Danish people love candles. And fun fact, they don't like scented candles. They prefer natural candles, or unscented candles, I should say, which is pretty interesting because I think in America, a lot of people prefer scented candles as opposed to the unscented ones. So funny difference there. You just want to make sure that your room is well aired out and that you're burning a candle that is clean or as clean as possible. I know soy candles are a good option. I'm actually on the lookout for a good 100% soy candle because those produce less soot, I've heard on the internet. But anyway, candle is a great way to add a little bit of like coziness and atmosphere to your room. And then also an actual fire, obviously that's another option, but maybe not for everyone and not for every room, which is where a fake fireplace comes in very handy. Because if you're sitting at your desk and you just want a little fake fireplace there, you can put it on your phone and enjoy that nice fireplace sight and sound. Now, I'm glad I mentioned that right now because the next point, and we're going to transition very nicely into it, is sound. Sound is another way to add a little bit of coziness, a little bit of relaxation to your space and to yourself. And actually, a crackling fireplace is so nice and really relaxing. Surprisingly, when I did try the fake fireplace, I was more enticed. That's not even the right word. What word am I thinking of right now? I don't know. I'm gonna rephrase the whole thing. Let's save us all some time. I liked the sound of the fireplace actually more than I liked the image of it. I thought the image was gonna be pretty much the whole deal, like there was gonna be nothing to it, but the sound made the biggest difference for me. So a soothing sound is a great way to add a little bit more of that relaxing, cozy atmosphere to your space. So you can listen to music, you can listen to a crackling fireplace, you can listen to nature sounds, or even people talking, characters that you like in, you know, in movies or TV shows. So that's tip number three. Tip number four is smell. I like how I remember everything. I don't even have to look at my notes. So tip number four is smell. Obviously, there's different ways to make your room or your home smell nice. One of my favorites is using aromatherapy because you can actually choose a scent that will be relaxing and that will be, well, cozy. Because part of being cozy is actually being relaxed, I think. So you can choose an aromatherapy scent or mix something yourself that will relax you and soothe you and give you that, you know, all the cozy feels. That's a way to do it. Obviously, a scented candle is a great way to do it. You can kind of check two things off at the same time, having a candle, having a nice smell to go along with it. And actually, it's also lighting, so maybe even three things you can check off. The main theme here for this point is that you just want to have a nice smell, because what you're trying to do is create an atmosphere of coziness. All right, so on to tip number five, which is, oh, this is one of my favorite tips. This is something I do all the time. I do not have any problems with doing this one a lot. Which is having a nice warm beverage along with optional a treat. So in the book, it talks about the kinds of treats that are best for hygge, but in terms of coziness, it really does not matter. Carrots are not as cozy as like a chocolate, for example, so I think you get that. As long as it makes you feel good, as long as you enjoy it, I think that counts as a treat. So it does not have to be anything particular or fit into any kind of a box. It does not even have to be like hygge approved. Whatever snack you like, you can add that on the side to a warm beverage. Now, I love to sip on warm beverages throughout the day, so let me give you my schedule. Just in case you're curious, because I think it's a pretty genius schedule. So first I have my coffee in the morning, 1 to 2 cups. I'm kind of in the process of getting or trying to find a mug that is ceramic, but also can hold like heat in pretty well, which apparently does not exist. Apparently ceramic does not hold heat well at all. I love a Yeti mug, but it's not very cozy, which is why I'm not holding it here right now to show you that. But anyway, so I do my coffee in the morning and then I do my caffeinated tea in the afternoon because I'm trying to like limit my caffeine as I go along through the day. And then in the evening, I have herbal teas, and I have so many teas because I love them so much and they're great. I know not everyone drinks coffee and or tea, so this is totally a personal preference, but having a warm beverage, even having like, you know, ginger and lemon, not even tea per se, but ginger and lemon in your hot water just warms you up a little bit and makes you feel cozy. Actually, as I'm saying that right now, holding a drink, in my psychology class in college, this is not gonna be boring, I promise. there was a study that was done which basically had participants hold either a warm cup or a cool cup of liquid, I think coffee. And then I think they asked the participants to do them a favor, something like that. And people that held a warm cup actually were more willing to do a favor and were warmer to the actors in the study. And then people that held like a nice coffee were not as willing to help them out and were not as warm. So I think there's something to it. I mean, that's, we do use those terms like warm person or cool or cold person. Not cool person, cold person. You know, like a warm personality or a cold personality kind of a deal. And there's definitely something to it. So a warm drink, whatever you like, is a great way to, again, add a little bit of coziness to that whole puzzle of coziness. So to go along with your drink, you can also have a delicious treat. And the book does talk a lot about just the love of sweets in Denmark, which I am so for because I have the biggest sweet tooth in the world. He was saying that for hygge, you don't want to have anything very fancy. You actually want to have something kind of more simple, more down to earth, because hygge and I think Danish culture in general, and I'm just speaking from the book because I don't know too much about it, although I have been to Copenhagen airport and ate a sandwich. It's Joe and the Juice. So maybe I have a little bit of something there, but I've never been to Denmark. I would love to go one day. But he was saying, back to the book, that you want to have something very kind of simple and down to earth and just like warming. So you want to have not like a salad or carrots, but rather maybe like a small piece of cake or some chocolate or a stew or some popcorn, something like that. Now, you don't have to have a lot of it. And he does say that instead of, you know, eating a lot of something, go, for example, to your local cafe or bakery and get a really good quality of something delicious and just have a small amount of that. And I 100% think that's a great idea, even though when push comes to shove, I tend to eat a lot more than just a small amount. So I have to pace myself when it comes to sweets, specifically chocolate, but that's a great way to add something small in addition to having a warm beverage. And again, it does not have to be a lot. And if you put it on a nice plate and really make it special for yourself, I think you're not gonna need to have a ton of it to really make yourself feel nice and warm and cozy. Okay, so we have two more tips, and the next one is cozy clothing. I know some of them are kind of, you know, basic tips, but I am gonna link everything that I love down below and that I use to make myself feel cozy and just to create a good atmosphere for myself. When I'm working from home or when I'm just spending time at home, it really does make a big difference to do that. So, cozy clothes. I will link the ones that I found recently down below, and hopefully they'll be still in stock. So anyway, comfy clothing is a really great and kind of essential way to feel cozy. I think that's probably the first thing that I think we will think about when someone says, oh, I want to feel cozy. I personally automatically think of like blankets and socks and that kind of a deal. So yes, comfy clothing is a must. I have a few pieces that I always keep on hand and close by in my closet just so that if I really need a little bit of extra TLC that day, I have them on hand if I'm working from home or if I'm spending time at home. And they include cozy socks, cozy slippers, which are a must, soft kind of blanket-like tops and sweatpants, and then really fuzzy, what am I doing? Really fuzzy, like blankety type sweaters or cardigans, and then vests. I have this one vest that I got from Old Navy that I'll have to link down below because it literally makes you feel like you're wrapped in a cloud because it's really puffy. And when you're leaning back in your chair, like you don't feel the stiffness of the chair, you actually feel like a cloud, like softness, because the vest is wrapping you up. So it's the best thing when you want to feel a little extra, like, I don't know, if you want to feel like you're hugged by a cloud or something. The point is that they need to be comfortable and soft and as plush as possible. So anything that's fuzzy, anything that is very soft and very comfortable, if it's uncomfortable, if it's too tight, that's that's not cozy. Now, last but not least, and this is the last tip of this video, is you want to create an atmosphere. And I saved it for last because I'm sneaky like that. But it's actually a really, really important tip. And I think one that I personally struggle with the struggle. I personally struggle with the most. And that is that you want to create an experience for yourself. You really want to set everything up nice and put in the effort, put in the time. And we're not talking about a huge amount of time, just a few minutes to set everything up nice, whatever you're doing, and really make the most of that setup and that situation. So let me give you a quick example. If I'm eating a snack, I'm usually not really putting it on a plate and making it nice and really, you know, enjoying myself. I'm just kind of like eating on the go or doing something on the computer or something like that. And I do that all the time still, even though I know that it's not the best way to go about it. But if I do put in the effort, if I do, and it's not a lot of effort either, if I do take, you know, a plate and put my snack on a plate, take a cup, you know, sit down, maybe take 15 minutes and, I don't know, get a magazine or go outside or something and just like enjoy myself for a few minutes and make it nicer, it changes everything. Same goes for anything else that you do. If you're, you know, if you're taking a shower, make it feel like a little bit of a spa or something. Again, it does not have to be anything crazy, but maybe wear a nice robe and get a nice shower gel that smells nice that you like. If you're working out at home, which I think a lot of us are nowadays, I have to start working out again right now because I kind of stopped for a few weeks while I was moving. Although moving does burn a lot of calories, as I find out, which is great. But if you're working out at home, for example, you know, get a few nice workout outfits and wear those instead of wearing like your regular home clothes to work out. It's just gonna feel nicer. It's just gonna feel like an experience rather than like another chore. And another thing is it's gonna break up your day a little bit as well, because you're gonna feel like you're transitioning from one activity to the other with the fullest intent of doing that as good as possible and really, you know, just making that the most that it can be. And I promise you, when I do it like that, it really, like, it transforms everything. Now, you guys, that was the last tip of this video, so I'm going to wrap this up, and I hope you enjoyed this. I know it's kind of a strange one maybe to make, but I was really compelled to do it after re-listening to the Little Book of Hygge, which I just realized I do every December. Like every December once a year, I have the urge to listen to the Little Book of Hygge, and it's great. I'm probably gonna continue doing that. Now, on that note, I hope you guys are having, again, a wonderful holiday season and a great winter wherever you are. And I hope you have a wonderful day. And I also hope to see you in the next video, which should be coming up shortly and not as long as some of my previous ones were. So hopefully I'm gonna get on my schedule and film a few videos a week and post a few videos a week. So stay tuned for that. Bye.